And y'all, it is Tuesday, December, not December, January 23rd. I am like way back in it. I'm trying to go back to December, y'all. I have just thrown a pizza in the oven. It is just me today again. Nick wanted to keep Mason an extra night, so it's just gonna be me today. We have found a car, going to deal with that Saturday, and I'll show you all that once it's done. I don't wanna show you and then it not work out, but we have found one. We've already made an offer on it, a deal, paid cash. It's done. We're just hoping that it works out. If it doesn't work out Saturday, then fine. But I'm stuck here till Saturday till we get this car situation sorted. But this house is a hot mess because I have no kids. My house is destroyed. I just took the weekend as it was. You haven't even seen the bedrooms or the bathroom. I've got a horrible water leak in the bathroom. I've got to call somebody to come and fix it. So yeah, I've got a lot to do. It's just me, kid free. It's 12 o'clock, fixing to eat some pizza. My coffee maker is not even washed. So I'm fixing to start the dishwasher, start a load of laundry, and we're gonna get some cleaning done today. I promised you my COVID cleaning video, so we're gonna do that today. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into it. While it's not in freezing temperatures, I'm hoping that I haven't checked today, but yesterday it was pretty warm. Yeah, it is like not cold at all today. It's very dreary because it's been raining off and on, but it is warm outside. I don't even need long sleeves. But sorry, because I am getting rid of this car when we get the new one Saturday, I need to get it cleaned out, take everything out of it. I'm not even cleaning it. I am just taking everything out of it. I'm gonna call the people to come and pick it up. So I need to get that done today if I can. So that car has got to get done. What I'm gonna do, I'm taking my trash can while this pizza is still cooking in the oven. I'm gonna start on the trunk. It still needs about 10 minutes on the pizza. I've got an empty tote outside. The stuff that I'm keeping, because I have not cleaned this car out in like since before Christmas, y'all. It needs done. I'm gonna take my empty tote and my trash can, and I've got a ton of trash out here that needs to go to the dump, which I'll deal with at a later date. Wish I could do it today, but there is no way to do that. I am going to throw the stuff in the trash that doesn't need to be kept, and I'm just going to throw everything in this tote right here that I'm keeping. It's a little wet, but it's okay. That way I can just deal with it later, but at least it's cleaned out and I can call them to come get it. As far as cleaned out, I just vacuumed up my room and the room Mason sleeps in, because now he's sleeping in his own room. But we're gonna get this bed made, and the little bit of stuff that needs cleaned up, we're gonna get it cleaned up in my room first, and then we're gonna go around the house. It's about 4 o'clock. I'm fixing to eat. I don't even know. It's 4 o'clock. I ate a little bit of lunch, but it was kind of like a brunch this morning. It was pizza because I got up late. What do you call like dinner and lunch put together? I just thought of that. They don't have a word for that. Brunch is breakfast and lunch, but what is dinner and lunch? I don't know. Maybe that's because you're not supposed to put it together. You're supposed to have two separate meals. But I'm gonna have some leftover of this beef tips and gravy with rice. I got my car fully cleaned out, proud of myself, got my bed made, and we're gonna get some more stuff done as soon as I get done eating. Hey y'all, it's the next day. I slept till 1 o'clock today. I didn't go to bed till 2. For some reason, I just could not sleep. Mason's coming back tomorrow. It was supposed to be today, but that's okay. He wants to keep him another day. Let him do it. He can have him, you know. We're co-parenting the best way we can. I'm running a hot bath. I am just exhausted. It's almost 2 o'clock now. I ate a late breakfast, lunch combined. I had like one of those chia If you've never had these, they're good. It's not sponsored, but it's by Del Monte. It's the fruit refreshers. It's the peaches and chia and dragon fruit, strawberry dragon fruit flavored water. It's good. Try them if you haven't. This is what it looks like, still eating on it. And then I had a Pop-Tart and some coffee. I got a lot done around here yesterday, if you can tell. But there's still some things I want to get done because I'm going to be gone most of the weekend. So me and Mason are going to be gone most of the weekend. I'm going to pick up my new car. Got to deal with the DMV stuff, and that won't be able to be done till Monday. So I'm going to be gone most of the weekend. So beside the point, I'm having a trouble waking myself up. So going to go take a shower or a bath, whatever. Going to curl my hair, do my makeup, feel alive again, and then we're going to get the rest of the stuff in the house that needs done. Done. I know a lot of people like brush it out. My hair does not hold curls, so like when I'm done with it, like curling it up, this is just how it is. I can't brush it out or it will all fall. I have really thick hair and it just doesn't hold. Never has my whole life. So anyways, plan for today. It's almost 3 o'clock, y'all, but it's okay. It's just me. I'm able to do that when it's just me. And I've noticed lately that just doing my hair and makeup has been really good for myself for self-care. So that's what I'm doing to make myself feel a little bit better about myself. And we just all need self-care. Whatever works for you, works for you. I know my lighting is awful, but I think the first place I want to tackle, I'm not tackling anything in the living room. I got in the kitchen. I did so much yesterday. I've still got a good bit to do. But I think the first place I want to tackle is Cooper and Mason's bedroom. Mason sleeps in my spare bedroom right now just because I can't put them in the same room. Just can't, because Mason, any little noise, he will wake up. And I cleaned that room up yesterday. I just didn't get to the bathroom from when I Cloroxed and bleached all those toys down. So I need to put all those up. But I think the first thing we're going to do is tackle Cooper's room. So I know y'all know I have all the toys in my living room, a lot of them, that like go to sets and stuff, but the way I've organized kind of their toys, like their personal toys, the living room toys are kind of toys that they share. Their personal toys, this is Cooper's handmade toy box. By the time Mason was born, my grandpa just can't build anymore. So this is Cooper's toy box. So all his personal stuff, like Legos and stuff in their boxes, go in there. His personal toys that he doesn't like to share go in there. And then Mason's personal toys go in there, and then they have that big collection of toys in the living room that they share. And that way I don't have to look at all this. I can just shut the door. But we're gonna get this cleaned up. I was kind of going through the closet the other day and just didn't get finished with it. This toddler bed is fixing to go. I'm planning to get a bunk bed for this room. So yeah, that's the plan, but we're living with it for right now. But yeah, we're gonna deal with these toys really quick.
So here I'm just separating the toys on the floor into the correct toy boxes from whose toy is which kid's toy, if that makes any sense. And not videoed right after this, I went through and went through their dressers and put the correct clothing back into where they go, because Cooper has a habit of picking out clothing and not putting it back into the correct spot if he decides not to wear it.
So I got some of Cooper's room done. I got the toys picked up and kind of organized the inside of the dresser drawers the way I like them, because sometimes I just have to go in really and do a quick clean out of those dressers, because Cooper likes to just pick out clothes, put them back wherever. So I went back and straightened those up. The water guy, or whatever, the guy that's coming to fix my bathroom with the leak, supposed to be on his way. He just called me, so my priorities have changed to the living room now, which was not going to be, I didn't want that to be my starting place this morning, but it's not morning, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. So my priorities have changed a bit. I went through last night, since I couldn't really sleep, went through the kids' Easter stuff, and I am like 75% done. I've got to get some Easter egg fillers, because my Easter egg fillers that I bought actually won't fit in the Easter eggs. And I need to get a few more things, like summer stuff to throw in their baskets. But other than that, I am done, and I got to get them some candy. But I've got this Peep 4-foot inflatable. So Easter is in like March this year. So I think I said March, it may be April, but I think it's late March. So it's early this year. It is like a week until February. So I'm going to go ahead and blow up this little Peep. I think she is just so cute and my kids will absolutely love it. So we're going to blow that up if we can. And I got, they had like three different colors, but I just loved this like tie-dye, like ombre look. So we're going to blow this up really quick and I'm going to figure out where I'm going to put it at. Also, the kids' Easter baskets from like last year. Sorry, you were like looking. Let me fix it. Okay. The kids' Easter baskets from last year, I absolutely love them. The only problem I have with them is that they are very, very flimsy. And they don't hold what I want them to hold, which is fine because I usually pile stuff next to their Easter baskets because I do like a certain type of basket. I like that seersucker boutique look. But I'm having problems with getting them to stand up. So if you have cloth Easter baskets like I do, let me know your tips and tricks on how you get them to stand up. I've tried, like last year I put clothing in the bottom of them and it worked perfect. But for what I'm putting in them this year, they are not wanting to hold with the clothing in the bottom. So I don't know if it's because I've had them for a whole year or what, but we got to get that figured out.